did I want to bring up? This was a strange one that happened when I was living in Hanoi. When I was visiting Hanoi, I was asked to come down to do some translating at a meeting. Now, I had never been at this location before. I'd never met any of the people that were at this location. I had no idea what I was walking into. So I was there with a couple other Americans, and this Vietnamese man walks in, and the other Americans introduced me to him. And the man, he looks at me and he goes, "I know who he is." And I was like, "What? What does that mean? I don't know what that means." And he asked them not to have me in the meeting. So I'm like, okay. So I had to leave. I wasn't allowed to be there. Not sure why. Perhaps he and his other colleagues wanted to speak Vietnamese when they were discussing things, so they didn't want anybody else to understand what was happening. I don't know. But it convinced me at that point that yes, someone somewhere has been watching me. Who? Well, you know, this was before cell phones. This is before I started willingly giving away my privacy. You know, and as I look back upon that time, it made me think about, you know, our current society where our privacy has been whittled away and we have more or less willingly embraced it. So my question, kind of to myself, was, do I really want to live in a society that tracks me, that tracks every little thing that I do? Now, there's a familiar response to a question like that, and it goes something like this. If you're not doing anything wrong, you have nothing to worry about. Really? So the innocent should just be inconvenienced and willingly give themselves over to be surveilled in the good name of catching the real bad guy? I'm not exactly buying that. You know, America has the technology to track you well beyond the ability of the Vietnamese at the time that I lived in Vietnam. Remember that Vietnam has a communist government, and they keep a tight rein on anything that might threaten their power. So the spying on me wasn't actually very shocking. But hey, we're in 2023. What about the privacy we have already ceded to our government?